blessing and a prayer, because I know how hard life can be and how discouraging times can come. But I know that your love for the Lord will bring me through whatever. And so I put these things down, that you would remember what I have seen in your life, what God has revealed to me. Dear Rachel, it's hard to believe how quickly those last 5 years have gone. Even though we have arrived at the 412 graduation, we have both agreed that our relationship will not end, but continue to grow as we continue our journeys of spiritual growth. In those journeys to, let's see, Chipotle and the park was a good one. She encouraged me to feed the ducks and the swans and the geese and the yeah, I learned a lot from Rachel. You've always been my ray of sunshine with your smiles and cheerfulness. You are also a ray of sunshine. The qualities of the Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, have been exhibited by you in many ways. Recently, as I was studying Ephesians 4 regarding spiritual growth, I immediately thought of you. Your love to understand God's word and to memorize it is inspiring. May you continue to grow and stand firm in the doctrine and share that love with others. I've been blessed to see you on occasion speaking the truth in love when you have observed less than Christ-like behavior in others,
especially my son.
May you continue to grow in all aspects into him who is the head, even Christ, in Ephesians 4:15. You've shown your concern for others when you ask if there's something you can pray for them, and then you follow up. Rachel is not only my mentee, but she's been my employee for the last couple years. And I was just so inspired to hear how Rachel was approaching different employees and asking them if there was something she could pray for them for. And then she would follow up later. And she shared with me that about her prayer wall in her bedroom. I thought that was such an excellent way of keeping those people on your mind and in your prayers. You show your love for others in your gift of helping. And I thought that was really interesting, your verse, Hebrews 10:6, because that is a gift that you have. It's a gift of helps. And you're always there. You've observed my struggles with my arthritis and offered your help as an employee at work and as a friend on the farm.
Mm-hmm. Rachel loves cows.
If you haven't seen that in her Facebook. So I really appreciate all that. That was fun. It's been a pleasure to see your cooperation in ministry. You have a great compassion for children and young people as you share Christ, not only by your conduct, but by your speech. May you continue to do your part in growing the body of Christ. My prayer for you as you continue on your journey is that you, and this is a prayer that I pray often for you from Scripture. It's found in Colossians 1, verses 9 through 12, and I'll continue praying that for you too. And it says this, that you may be filled with the knowledge of His will and with all wisdom and understanding, so that you will walk in a manner worthy of the Lord, to please Him in all respects, bearing fruit in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God, strengthened with all power according to His glorious might, for the attaining of all steadfastness and patience, joyously giving thanks to the Father who has qualified us to share in the inheritance of the saints in light. May God continue to bless your life as you grow in your love for Him and in your love for others. I love you so much. See you.